So before we go on to the next example, Michael, I wanted to do a quick quiz just to make certain you really get what's going on here, the sort of power of looking using Bayesian learning. The main insight, I think, I want to drive home here is something that you said, which is that when we were doing regression before and we were talking about perceptrons, we actually had in our head a particular kind of function, a particular hypothesis class. And here, with what we've been talking about with Bayesian learning, the answer of finding the sum of squared errors was independent of the hypothesis class and only dependent upon the key assumptions that we were making, namely that we had labeled data of a certain form and that that data was generated by a process that took a deterministic function and added some Gaussian noise to it. So here's the quiz. Here's your training data. You've got a bunch of X's and a bunch of D's. These are the values that you have to learn. And I want you to tell me which of these three functions over here, these three hypotheses, is the best one under this assumption. Got it?
Mod? Are we allowed to do that?
We are allowed to do that because
it's just a function.
It's just a function, man.
Interesting.
It's just a function.
So we've got a constant function, a linear function, and we've talked about those, but we've also got a mod function. All right. And we've got a uniform prior over these three hypotheses?
Yep.
Okay. Yeah, I think I can do that.
Okay. Go.